ready for our first session of today. Our expert speaker for this first session, Mrs. Tanya Pathakgarg, is already there with us. Ma'am will be highlighting the different various user roles that are there in Moodle. So I request ma'am to kindly start with the session.
Thank you so much, ma'am. A very good afternoon to dear participants of the ongoing refresher course with BVIM. I welcome you all on the third day of our 1 week long hands-on training workshop with Moodle LMS. So far, we have seen how we install an on-premise Moodle server, how we create our own Moodle site. Then we have gone about seeing what a admin dashboard has to offer and what are the different kinds of courses and category creation options available in Moodle. Then yesterday we discussed how to add resources to an existing Moodle course. Today, carrying forward the discussion, I'll be discussing various types of users in Moodle. Users are the heart and core of any LMS. So we'll be discussing what are the different user roles present in Moodle. We'll be creating users and allocating them few of our user privileges that we discuss. So let's begin. So Moodle has different user roles to offer according to the usage of every category. To begin with, the basic Moodle user role is called the administrator, or also known as the site administrator. This user role is the super user or the heart and core whole soul owner of a Moodle LMS site. When you install Moodle servers on-premise, you create one default user privilege at the time of installation, and that is of an admin or a site administrator for Moodle. This is the super user who remains same throughout the Moodle installation. Probably you can edit a few fields, but you can never delete a site administrator. Site administrator has super user privileges over all other different kinds of roles. And in a way, from the site administrator privilege itself, we are going to create different types of roles and users available in Moodle. So site administrator, being the heart and core basic user role, were further enhanced Moodle 2.0 onwards to a more restricted privileged role called the managers. Now, managers are similar to site administrator, but with certain lesser privilege set. The main intent of a manager is that he or she can create a course, modify them, but usually do not participate in a course. Also, managers are created from the site administrator role. So you can edit or delete managers within a system, but you can't do that for a site administrator. By the name suggesting, managers are intended to manage a particular Moodle site. So they can create different kinds of other roles, as well as modify courses, change content within the courses, restrict privilege of other user roles as well. The next type of role available with us in Moodle is that of a course creator. As the name suggests, course creators are either created by administrators or managers, and they are intended to change or create the content within a course. They create a course, they are used to create new courses, they are used to even give privileges or assign teachers to courses. And once the course creator creates a new course, they're usually enrolled into the course by default with the role of a course creator. So that is another specialized category of a user role called course creators. Then a very familiar role to all of us is that of a teacher. Teacher roles are those which are used to, first of all, they are assigned to a course and they are used to modify the content, update resources, track student activities and progress, and in a way logically conduct all the activities of an ongoing course. So all users will be assigned the teacher privilege by default, have the editing roles with them. Teachers in Moodle, or the teacher role in Moodle, comes in two flavors. One is the editing teacher role, another is the non-editing teacher role. As I mentioned on day one, an editing teacher role is one where a teacher can add, update or delete content within a course and edit the format of how the course looks to the student, or probably make some gradings to the assignments that the students turn in. But a non-editing teacher role is that just supervises the functioning of a course. For example, we have in our physical scenario, there is a teacher for a practical subject and there is a lab attendant. Also, there might be two teachers teaching for the same course, one in an evening batch, another in a morning batch, out of which we'll say we are giving editing privileges just to one teacher. So this is the teacher role which is available in Moodle. All these roles that I'm talking about They are assigned to existing users. So our first step will be to user, and then we'll assign any role privilege to that particular user. So once we create a normal user, we can make that user a teacher by enrolling the user in a particular course. This can be done by administrators, managers, so on and so forth. This course enrollment part, where you enroll teachers and further enroll students into a course, either through manual methods or through voluntary enrollment or open enrollment schemes, this will be taken up in the second half of today's session by Uttam sir. In the first half, I will only be detailing how we create different users and how we allocate certain user roles to those users. Course enrollment of teachers, students, and further activities will be taken up in the second half. Next role that we have in Moodle is that of a student. They are the main benefiters of a Moodle LMS or any LMS content present online. Students are used to enroll within a course, either through manual enrollment or self-enrollment mechanisms, and they are used to benefit from the material within the course. They can attend synchronous as well as asynchronous learning models, and they can be the main benefiters of a course. Only difference between the student role and that of the earlier discussed is that student is a non-editing role. It cannot change the content, it cannot change the resources, it cannot update whatever is present on your Moodle LMS site. But they can go through those resources, they can participate in activities, assignments, surveys, quizzes, examinations, all those sort, but they can't alter the structure of your Moodle course. That privilege is only present with the teacher, course creator, or manager site administrator. So students, this is the next role that is present in Moodle. The last role is that of a guest. So if your user or the person who's intending to use your Moodle site is not present as a valid user within your Moodle system, which means you have not created a user in the Moodle system and you want to allocate a guest privilege to some account, meaning to say I can access the Moodle site without having any user ID or password. So this is the most restrictive role of all kinds, wherein I can only view some of the content which is available for public access as a guest. So the next type of role is said to be that of a guest. So these are the different user roles that are present in Moodle. Now we'll be proceeding to our LMS, Moodle LMS. So I'll request you all those who have an on-premise installation, please start your XAMPP server, log in into your Moodle site through your ID password. So all those who have an on-premise installation, all of you will be by default the site administrator or the admin user privilege for that site. But some of you who will be using the cloud version will not be site administrators. Uttam sir must have given to you some user ID password. So the maximum privilege that you'll be getting there will be of a manager. So that is fine. As and when I go about the practical demonstration, I will mention a few areas where you might see differences in our cloud implementation and the on-premise implementation that you are using. So I'll request everybody to start your XAMPP server, log in into your Moodle site, either on-premise installation or the cloud version, and please confirm in the chat box. I will need all of you to be on this landing page or the dashboard for your Moodle application. If you are using the cloud version that is shared by Uttam sir, in certain areas you will find a little difference because of the privilege. You're not the site administrator for the cloud account. So that I will detail as and when I go about the practical demonstration. But as of now, all those who are able to log into any Moodle site, either on-premise or cloud, please confirm in the chat box. I will wait for everyone to be on the same page, so that we start together. Great. Waiting for others to confirm. If anyone is facing any problems logging into the accounts, you can please let me know. Okay, so to begin with, this will be a landing page whether we log in into the Moodle account using any of the user roles. So all the demonstration that we are going to do today for user role creation and allocation will be under the section of site administration. You can see this last option that I get on my left panel, that is the site administration. We'll not be looking into any course. We'll not be working with any of the categories or courses, resources that you created till yesterday. We will be working under site administration. So click on site administration. This will lead you to the basic site administration page that you must have witnessed on the first day of the FDP or the second, where you created courses and categories. So under the site administration panel, you can see the third tab to be of courses and categories. Here, Uttam sir must have demonstrated how we create courses and categories, how we allocate courses within existing categories, and so on. So today, we're working with the second tab here, just besides courses, that is users. So every functionality that you want to perform as far as user management goes in Moodle is done under site administration and user tab. We'll just be working on this tab for the entire session today. So this tab has further sections to it of user accounts, permissions, privacies and policies and so on and so forth. So first of all, in the first tab of accounts, we can see there is an option of browse list of users. If you click on this option, this will lead you to a page where you can see all the existing users in your Moodle system. Now, the output of this page or what is displayed on this page can vary if you're working with an on-premise installation or if you're logging into the cloud account. So, if you're logging into the cloud account, you may see many more users created apart from just one admin user. But I'm working on my own on-premise implementation. So I have just one user created. That is the admin user using which I've logged in into the Moodle site. And this admin user I have created at the time of installation. So ideally, there has to be one user in the system, one basic user in the system that does not change for the entire installation. And that is the administrator. This is created when you install the Moodle site. So we can see here, list of all users on this page. Now, ideally, if there are many users created in your account, because that will be the scenario since you'll be taking up classes. So there will be teachers, there will be a list of students from many years, many semesters. So this list will ideally grow up till a very long section beneath. Hence, there are some intelligent search filters where you can search throughout the list of users using these filters like contains, equal to, starts with, end with. You can write anything and the filter will apply the regular expression to the user full name and search for the user that you're looking on in this page. But right now, we don't want to use those filters because we don't have so many users created in our system. So we have just one user for now, admin user. And as I said, you cannot delete the admin user. So if we see, besides the admin user in the last section, we get only one option to edit the admin user account. So if I click on this option, then this leads to the basic information of the admin user account that I filled in while installing my Moodle site. I can change the credentials, I can add some new information, I can have a password change, fill in the information that I must have skipped, like a country or a time zone. Make sure your time zone is always Asia, Kolkata. You can select a country, add other fields which you might have left at the time of installation, and you can only click on update profile. So all that is available to you when it comes to an admin user is that you can update the user. You can update details of the user. You cannot delete the user. So last access was, it shows me the timestamp 48 seconds ago, and there is no option to delete this user. Now, what is available here on this page, apart from the list of all users that are present in your Moodle account, is a button that says add a new user. So in order to add a new user, there are two types of methods. Either we can have single user additions, single manual user updates, wherein we add every user account individually, or we can have a bulk user update. So now imagine if you have 60 students in your class. So ideally, going about creating accounts for those 60 students manually will be a very lengthy and lethargic process. So in order to achieve that sort of a purpose, you also have an option of bulk user operations, bulk addition, bulk deletion. So we'll be witnessing that after we cover single user account creation and deletion. So right now, if I click on add a new user, this will lead me to a page which might be pretty similar to the one you would have witnessed while installing the Moodle LMS and creating your admin user. So this page is used to create just one single user account. As I said, as a part of the basic convention of Moodle LMS, the fields that are necessary or mandatory have a red exclamation mark besides them. Rest all the fields which are optional don't have that exclamation mark. If you want certain detailing or you want to know certain additional information about a field like the username, right? So you can click on this question mark and it will give you some additional information on this field as to what is to be done. So I'll be creating a new user account. Username, say, how do you want to authenticate the account? You want the email-based self-registration or you want to manually create the account? We will not select no login because otherwise we will skip the user ID password. I want the user to have a user ID password. So I'll click on manual account. Do you want it to be a suspended account? Meaning to say you will just create the account and it will behave as a disabled or suspended account in your system. Later on going forward, you can probably enable the account if you want. So this kind of a functionality is useful when you have students passing out from your college. So all the user accounts of the students who have just passed out can be suspended. We don't want to hard delete them, so we make it suspended or disabled as a soft delete option. So I say I don't want this option to be clicked. I want the account to be active when I create it, so I'm not going to suspend the account. The next checkbox says here, you want to generate a user ID and notify the user, you generate a password, because there are certain rules which need to be followed when you want to have passwords set in. So it gives you an option to have a system generated password that will be notified to the user, and upon first login, the user can change the credential according to his or her own wish. So this option is feasible when you are creating an account for your students. So you can create a default password for your students by clicking on this generate password and notify user checkbox. And later on, when the student accesses the site for the first time, he or she can change the password according to their own liking. So I say, no, I'm the user of this account and I want to create my own password. So click on this option, new password. Now your password has to be the same following these rules. Must have at least 8 characters, 1 digit, 1 lowercase, 1 uppercase, 1 alphanumeric. So I'm keeping the password simple, Moodle at 123. You can see the password that you are setting. If you want to force a password change on the first use, check this checkbox, otherwise leave it unchecked. These fields are mandatory, that is the first name, surname and email address. It will not verify the validity of an email address. It will only check for the format. So if in the same format you give an invalid email address also, it is going to accept. Then how do you want the email to be displayed? You want it to be hidden from other users, non-privileged users. You want everyone to see the email ID, or you just want the course members to see the email ID. So I say I just want the course members or students enrolled in the course to see my email ID. Moodle Net Profile, if you have registered your Moodle site at the time of installation, then you can give a link or you can allocate the same Moodle Net Profile to this account. I have not registered my Moodle site at the time of installation, so I'm going to skip this field. All these other parameters are optional. You can select a country and select time zone to be Asia, Kolkata. Preferred language, English. Then certain user base options like profile picture, so on and so forth. So we are not going to fill in all the information if you are going to create an account for some other user. We are just going to give the mandatory fields, make sure that what is required for user account creation is given, and the rest is left to the person to add and update as he or she wants. Additional names, if you want to give some alternate information, say surname, middle name, alternate name, you can provide those information in this text. Interest, if you want to give some tags, like we have discussed tags yesterday, if we are having a course with a hashtag, say hashtag DBMS, so we want to provide the same hashtag here, we can tag this user account, otherwise you can leave it blank. Then other optional parameters, any IDs, MSN ID, institution, department, if you want to fill it you can, otherwise if you don't it will still accept. So click on create user. So now we can see it takes us to the same page of browse list of users, and now I have two users. I have one is my admin user and another one is the user I just created. Now if you see, with the user account that I just created, there are certain additional options which are available which were not present with my site administrator. One of which being the enable and disable. This button either suspends the user account or activates it, and next is of the delete option. So here we can see if the admin is creating any user, admin user has the privilege to perform these operations upon that user account, right? So this is one way of creating user accounts or adding a single user to a system. Right now we have just created a single user. We have not allocated any privilege to the user. If I want to make this user as a manager or a course creator, or if I want to enroll this user into some other course or activity, I will show you that separately in the second part. First part, all users in your system, be it teachers, managers, course creators, students, everybody first need to have a user account into your Moodle system. So this is one way of creating the user account, where in the browse list of user option, you have this functionality, you have this button to add a new user. Now, if we go back again to site administration, users tab, we witness this user, browse list of user, we witness this option. Next option that we see here is add a new user. We'll skip bulk user operations for now. But if I directly click on add a new user, you can see the same page opens up. This is the same page that I used to create a user account from browse list of users. So if you want to add every user singly, like one by one, I want to create user accounts, then I can do that either from browse list of users or I can do that from add a new user option in accounts section. So let's create another user. I'll give her first name and surname. Email address. How the email needs to be displayed, I want to let it remain the same. Selecting the country and just the time zone. Just I don't want to fill in any optional parameter and I say create user. Password, I forgot, so I'll just add here. Same password. Moodle at 123. So again, this leads me to the list of user page. Now where I have three user accounts, one admin user and two user accounts that I created manually. By default, a user will have no role man. He'll just be a simple user into the system. If you want to allocate a role to a user, you have to do it specifically. He'll not be a teacher. He'll not be site administrator or anything. Just be a Moodle user. So we have to allocate a role if you want to give certain additional privilege to the user. With this role, the user can only log in into the Moodle site and perform whatever functionality is visible to him. If he or she is not enrolled into a course, will not be able to see the contents of that course. So now we have three users here. So we've seen how we create a user, either from browse list of user, we press this button, add a new user, or from the account section, we directly move on to add a new user and we create a user. Now, if I want to edit the user account after creation, I can do that using the setting option. This will lead to editing mode. What if I want to delete the user account? I've created a user by mistake and I don't want that user to be there in my Moodle system. So this option, I'm on the browse list of user, the first option in the users page. So with every user, there is this option of delete. So I want to say delete this user. It'll ask me for a confirmation that are you absolutely sure that you want to completely delete, hard delete the user that you have just created. All their activities, enrollments, and other data will also be deleted the moment a user account gets deleted. So you'll have no record of the user into your Moodle system once you suspend, once you delete the account. So I say, yes, I'm sure, delete the user account. So after deletion, I can see again, there are two users here, admin user and the user that I just created right now. Third user has been deleted. So this is how you create a single user account and how you delete a single user account. You can delete it when you go to site administration, users tab, browse list of users. So here comes the option to delete a user. And here is the same option to add a user. So these are single account operations where there is one user account, you want to create that account and you want to edit or delete that account. You can do that individually here. Next is we'll again be moving to site administration, users. Now I want to upload users, which means so far I've just been adding one user one by one and I've been deleting one by one. If there are suppose 60 user accounts that I have to create, how do I create those accounts? I go to the upload user section. So in the users page, account section, you see this option here, second last option, that is upload users. Click on this. Now, if you have to upload a set of users, if you want to create a set of users together within a Moodle system, you have to do it in a file format. You have to present your information in a file format, which is accepted by Moodle, upload the file, and then Moodle is going to process and create all those user accounts. Now, what is the format of the file and what information mandatorily should you be giving to create user accounts in bulk? For that, Moodle has given a sample file, that is an example.csv file, which is a comma separated file, comma separated values. You can click on this file and the file will get downloaded. If I open this file, you can see here. A CSV file by default opens up as an Excel file if you click on it. Otherwise, it's a list of comma separated values if you open it in the notepad. You can see here in this file, the first row specifies my headers, the necessary details which I want to give. If you see these details, username, first name, and email, these were the mandatory parameters when we were creating user accounts in Moodle. So these parameters, when we create a single user account, were coming with a red exclamation mark. So now if I want to upload more than one users together, I can upload this by uploading a file, and these are the mandatory details that I need to give. Apart from this, there is many more information like your profile picture, you have country, time zone, password, everything. Here only mandatory fields will be these. The moment you change details into this file, this first row needs to remain the same. Second row onwards, you can start changing information, right? So let's change information. Like we have student one, for ease, I'm going to create user one. First name will be user. Make sure you don't give any capital letters in the username. It has to be just small caps. Last name, email ID if you want to change, because I'm just going to do a dummy creation. So if you want to change, you can. Otherwise, you can give the same email ID. User 2, email ID I don't want to change, and user 3. That's it. Save the file. Now, you see here, we are just giving username by which the user is going to log in, what will be the first name and last name of the user, and the email ID related to that account. We are not setting up passwords. So from where will passwords come? If you remember, right now we saw in add a user, there was an option to auto-generate a password. So for all these accounts, when we create these accounts, there will be a password that will be automatically generated, and the details, username and password, will be sent to this email ID, wherein the user can access the credentials, change it upon his first use. So here you don't need to specify password, system will automatically generate passwords. These are the mandatory fields which need to be present into the Excel file. You can save them. Now I'll be picking up this file or reading this file from the location that I have downloaded it. I'll say this, see here in this upload user page, only field mandatory is the file. So choose a file, upload file, downloads. You can pick it up from whichever location you have downloaded it and pick down. Once you upload the file, it will be present here. Now it is asking you if you want to change the CSV delimiter. It's a comma separated values file, so all values are separated by comma. If you want to change the delimiter to be anything, semicolons or a colon, anything, you can do that. Otherwise, if you're just editing in Excel, let the separator be comma. Then next is UTF encoding of the characters present. I don't want to change. It has to be UTF-8. Now, if the file has many values, then upon user creation or upon user upload, how many default number of rows do you want to witness on one page? Let this be 10 because I've just uploaded 3 users. So this value to be 10 is fine. I say upload users. Now, this is a preview of all the values that we added into the Excel sheet, and we can see these values here. First line has been read as your column headers, which you should not change. Second line onwards, the details that I added are visible here. Now, before creating the user account, it will ask me for certain confirmations. First is add only new users or skip existing users. Or if you want to add duplicate users or update only existing users, you can change whichever option that you want here. Next is new users, new user password. How do you want the password? Are you specifying the password in the file? I'm saying no, I'm not specifying the password in the file. You can create a password and send it to the user by the email account which I have mentioned into this file. Then standardize usernames, yes. Select for bulk user actions, no. I don't want to select any bulk user actions right now. I just want to perform the operation of user addition. Then if any additional parameter you want to set for the users, how you want email to be displayed, or any institution department, you can specify this information will replicate for all user accounts in the file, not just one, because we are doing a bulk user upload. I'll say just upload users. So now it shows me users created 3, users having a weak password 0, because all passwords were system generated and strong, and errors none. So I say continue. Go back to site administration. Users, browse list of users. The user accounts that I just uploaded in bulk. So rather than having to edit and add every user individually, I have uploaded just an Excel sheet, and the Excel sheet shows me the list of all users that I want to create on the same page. So this is called bulk user upload. If you have to upload user accounts for your students, then you can do that using this option. So there are some questions in the chat box. Yes, sir, we can create bulk user account instead one by one, just like how I showed using the bulk user upload option. We can upload an Excel file, a CSV file actually. Yeah. You can upload data from multiple sheets. You can upload the sheets one by one. So like we have just uploaded one sheet, example.csv. You can upload many sheets. You can first upload first sheet, then second sheet. So all user accounts will be created into the system. All your data does not necessarily need to be in one sheet. Any further questions? Anybody is facing a problem till this point? Single user creation, single user delete, bulk user upload. We have seen 3 options right now. We are on to creating users first. Once we have users created into our system, then we are going to assign roles and privileges to these users. So we have seen user creation so far. Any doubts anywhere anybody is facing a problem in practical implementation?
Ma'am, what to give in this tools and authentication method?
Where, ma'am?
What to give, like I'm trying to add a user.
Okay.
The username I have given, after that it is tools and authentication method.
Yeah, so we can have manual accounts.
Manual account.
Yeah. Otherwise, if it is an email-based self-registration, it will give the user a link for registering and creating the account. So user can fill in all details, password and all himself. So no, it's a manual account creation. Whatever details I am putting in, just let that be. And if we want to skip the credential part, if we want the user to just directly access the Moodle system without user ID password, then we select no login. Otherwise, we give manual accounts. Yeah, so you will be creating, ma'am, all users into the Moodle system, just like how I mentioned, you can have bulk user updates. So all users, be it your first year, second year, third year, or any batches, morning batch, evening batch, every user will be there in the system simultaneously. Only difference will be you will be allocating a subset of users, say 60 users to first year. So you will be allocating those users or enrolling those users to first year courses, first year classes. Then set of 60 more users to second year courses. Enrollment will differ, but all users will exist in the system as it is. For the Moodle LMS, they are just users. But for your demarcation, you will be segregating them on the basis of their year of study in the course. So the difference will be one user, a second year student will not be able to access the first year course because he'll not be enrolled in the first year course. That is why I also mentioned this option of disabling users. So we have the suspend user account. So if you have students in your third year and they have been enrolled into a course in Moodle, now they have passed out. So you want your student information to be suspended. You want their accounts to be suspended. So you can suspend all their accounts using bulk user actions. I'll be demonstrating that next. Or you can probably delete all those students also if you want. We've seen how to browse a list of users, add new user. To add a user, you can select add user button from browse list of users or this option here, third option, add a new user. And then we have seen upload users. Three options we have seen. You can delete a user also from the browse list of users where all user information is displayed. You can delete or disable, suspend account. Just if you want to see, ma'am, if your user has been added, then go to site administration. On this page, users tab, select on browse list of users. So you will be able to see the new user account that you created. It should be visible in this page.
Ma'am, like I am using the cloud base, so there are many users already. The number has all increased from 102 to 103, but I am not, but there are so many users, it is coming alphabetical wise.
Then you can search here, ma'am. You see this
Okay, we
option,
have to search.
user full name. You can search. You can have any filter. You can make it a more specific search. If I search the
Okay,
option for
I
Sriram,
got it. Yeah, I got it. But ma'am, this user allocation is like if this is the admin or the manager is doing this, then he's like for, let's say for the 2020, we have a new set of students. So we will first add them as users in a
Yes,
bulk.
yes, ma'am.
The new admission people will be added as a user, and then after on, we'll be putting them in different categories, first year, second year, third year, like so.
Absolutely, ma'am. Absolutely. First step to any user operation in Moodle is creating a user, be it your students, be it your teachers, be it course creators, managers, anybody. They will first be added as users. Then you can allocate certain specific roles to those users. You can make a user to be the manager or a teacher or a course creator or anything. And then if you want, you can enroll those users into courses. So when we talk of teacher and student roles, they come as enrollment options. A teacher and a student is ideally enrolled in a course. So even for enrollment, the base is user creation. Everything will exist as users into your system. Only then will you proceed with further options. Anybody else have any questions, facing any difficulty? If the demonstration till this point is clear, then please confirm in the chat box. If you have any questions, please feel free to write in the chat box or unmute yourself. So now let's move to the next option of bulk user actions. So we click on the second option available under the account section, that is bulk user actions. So this bulk user action is used to perform actions on a set of users rather than individually performing certain action on one user. If you want to perform bulk user operations on a set of users, like if you want to send them an email, if you want to do anything related to their account, then first of all, we have to select the set of users. Now, if you see here, first option on this page is for a filter. If you want to select for a group of students, if you want to perform a user action on first year students, or if you want to perform certain actions on a set of students, you can filter them out and perform action on those set of users. Otherwise, all list of users within the system, I have five users in my system, one of which is a site administrator, rest four I have not allocated any role so far. They are just users in my Moodle system. So all list of users within my system is available in the left panel, right? This works as you have two panels here, left and right. If you want to select a set of users, so say if I want to select Sia and I say add to selection. So it will pick up user Sia Kumar and it will add to my selected area. It will not remove from here. It will only add. So now what is my selected set? What is the bulk that I'm working on? Sia. If I want to add user one, I'll say add from selection. This will add user one from all set of users to my selected panel. So in order to perform bulk operations, you first need to select a set of users. How to select those set of users? Either one by one you add to selection, or if by mistake you have added a user and you want to remove from selection, you can do that also. So what will happen? The user is removed from the selected panel. It will not be affected in the left panel. Left panel will remain as it is. It will always display all list of users. But the right panel will display only selected set of users. Either you individually pick up and add, or you individually remove. Now if I say there are many users and I want to perform some operation on all users, I want to put all these users under my selected set or under my selected panel. So I will say add all. In that case, all users into my system will be added into this panel. If I want to say remove all or clear my selected section, I can do that like this also. Now there will be one scenario. If you out of five users, I want to add three users to my selection and I don't want to add them one by one. I want to add them together, but just three of them. So how do I do that? Select one user. Press control, select another user. Press control, select the next user. Right? So I have selected three user accounts. I'll do that again. Select one user, press control, second user selected. Press control, third user selected. Right? So this way, out of five, I want to add three to selection, but at the same time, not one by one. So I will select these three and I'll say add to selection. So now I have three users in my right panel, which have been selected for bulk operations, right? So the first task is to select your set of users on which you want to perform some bulk operation. So this is how we do that. We move all selected users to the right panel. Once we have our selection in place, once we have selected the set of users that we want to work upon, the next thing that we'll do is we will select our bulk operation. What to do with these users? So if you scroll down, there is this third option with the selected users. Do this operation. What? Confirm their selection, send a message, delete, display their information on a page, download their details, force password change or add to cohort. Now cohort, you can think of it to be like a group of users. Now a question that I've been witnessing here is that we have many students and all students will be appearing all together in the same user section. Like all of them will be users in the system. Yes. But there is also an additional feature with Moodle that is called cohorts. Cohorts are actually group of students, logical grouping of students. How do you want to group those students is up to you. You want to group them roll number wise, you want to group them class wise, year wise. Every functionality is possible. So cohort is actually a logical group of students. Group you can only formulate once you have uploaded the students. So if you have, say, 120 students or 120 users in your system, out of which you want to have 60 users as first year students. So you have to enroll 60 users into a first year course. So rather than manually enrolling one by one every user into the course, what we do here is after we upload all users into the Moodle account, we can group them in a cohort. We can make a cohort of, say, first year. Then we make a cohort of second year. So I'll be demonstrating right after this option how we create cohorts and how we add users to cohort, right? So cohort is actually a logical group of students. So this way, out of all 120 users in your system, first of all, they will be users. You have to add users. Out of all 120 users, 60 users will belong to cohort 1. 60 users will belong to cohort 2. So then whatever operations you want to perform, you can perform on the basis of cohort, right? So either you can add students to cohort using this bulk operation. You can select all first year students, add them to selection, and then send add them to a new cohort, or you can do that by the separate cohort operation on the user page also. We will see how that works. But with the selected set of users, if you want to perform any bulk operation, all your options are available here. So if you want to send a message or if you want to delete users, download their information, anything, and you want to do that for more than one users, you can perform bulk operations using this option. That is bulk user actions. Just present inside site administration, users, bulk user actions. Right? So your selection remains even if you lose your connection or if you visit the page again, your selection will remain. Right? So like we deleted every users individually by creating on the delete icon or the dustbin symbol beneath the user account. If you want to delete these three users together, I don't want to delete them one by one. So I can click on delete. And then if I press go, it will lead me to a confirmation message that you really want to delete these users, yes or no. So I'm not proceeding with those options because I don't want to delete, but you can do it this way. So we have seen single upload, bulk upload, then we have seen single deletion and bulk deletion. Four operations as far as user accounts have been completed. So remove from selection, remove all. So your selection is now clear. Let's move to the concept of cohorts. So under site administration, users, one option is that you have your users created and you add them to cohort using bulk user actions. Next here, if you see third last, there is an option present in the account section that says cohorts. Click on cohorts. Now, there is no cohort available in your system, so it is not displaying anything. System cohorts, none. All cohorts, nothing. It gives you two options, add a new cohort and upload cohort. So if you want to add a new cohort, this means like creating a new folder and then adding items into the folder, creating a new group and then adding existing users into that group. So here we will create a cohort and we will add students into the cohort. But to add students into the cohort, we have to have students being already present as users within the system. Now, if you don't have system students present as users within the system, and you say, I want to upload 60 user accounts and I want those 60 user accounts to be a part of a logical group or a cohort called first year, then this gives you an option to upload users as well. So cohort functionality works both ways. Either have users and add users to cohort using bulk user operation, or add a new cohort and then we'll add members to the cohort, or rather than creating users in the beginning, create users and simultaneously add them to a cohort. Both ways you can function. So like in case of bulk user operation, where we had to upload an Excel file, and that Excel file or CSV file had a list of user accounts that we created, user 1, user 2, user 3. You can upload a CSV file here and same CSV file and upload them as a cohort, as a part of cohort. Only additional thing will be after you upload the file, it will lead you to a confirmation channel that says, okay, enter the details of the cohort. So let's see this option first, add a new cohort. Now I have three users, user one, user two, and user three. I want them to be a part of cohort and I want to call it the first year. So I say this is my cohort, first year. Context will be system level. The cohort has to exist at the system level or it has to exist pertaining to a particular course. So it is better you have the cohort existing at the system level because it's not necessary that the student will be a part of just one course. Student will be enrolled in multiple courses. So let's make the cohort visible at the system level. Cohort ID, if you want to present any ID, up to you. You want the ID to be visible and you want to give a description. I say no description required, just save changes. So now here, system level cohort, I see I have a cohort first year, ID F101. I'm not given a description and the size is zero. This has been created manually, right? This has not been created by bulk user upload and adding to a cohort option. Now, if I say I want to add some users to a cohort, I've created a logical group. Now I have students and I want to add them to this cohort. This will be a more usable option for you. You will be using this kind of a mechanism where you already have user accounts and you just add them to new cohorts more than the option of upload cohorts because it will be in first year, you will be uploading student information, you will be creating user accounts. And you will be adding those first year students to first year cohort. Then when the students move to second year, you will not be recreating their accounts. Their accounts will already be present inside the Moodle LMS. All that you will be doing is you will be changing the cohort from cohort first year to cohort second year. So this option we'll be using more logically and more frequently. We'll not be creating accounts every year. We'll be changing existing accounts into cohorts. So if I want to add students into this cohort, if you see here, we are very familiar with these three options. One is for edit the setting sign. Then there is delete the cohort. You want to make the cohort visible and invisible, hide or suspended or active. You see this option here, this is new to us, fourth option that says assign, right? It has a lot of people-based symbol and it says assign. So we click on assign. Then first year cohort, current users, none. Potential users, all users in the system. So initially everything is a user. Every user account is to be present into the system and then it is allocated privileges, it is added to cohort, it is enrolled within courses. So I say these three students, user one, user two, and user three, add them to the cohort. Right? Now this is just done. You just select and put it into the left panel. It will say add. It will not give you any like output as to okay, successful addition or anything. Just click on back to cohorts. You will see the cohort size now changes to three. If you want to see what are the three user accounts or which members are a part of this cohort, click again on people option. So current users, you will see list of all users within the cohort. Right. So this is the functionality where we have created a logical group of students. Everything has to be a user first. Only then can you allocate it to a cohort, assign privileges, and Moodle makes it even more simple for you. Although it does not recognize our logical demarcation of first year, second year, or a morning batch, evening batch, but it understands that you need to logically group certain users within one category. Right. So it understands that kind of a demarcation, which we can use up to our flexibility as to we want to have cohorts year-based or batch-based or roll number-wise or whatever. Right. So this is available under site administration, users, account section, third last option, cohorts. Right. So this is how you create a new cohort by first adding a new cohort, the third option here. And once you have created cohort, it will be displayed at the system level cohort, and then you assign users using this option. Second, the fourth option here, people symbol. you assign users to this code, right? So that is the logical demarcation of how you create groups, user groups within Moodle. The only significance of cohort is that it's a logical group. Now you can allocate or assign this group to a course. You can get it enrolled in a course. You can give an email or, you know, force password change or perform any bulk operation upon this cohort. It is possible. To site administration, users tab. So we have seen addition, deletion, update, bulk, and manual. And we have seen what are cohorts or logical group of users, how to create a cohort, and how to add users to a cohort. Anyone has a question or a doubt so far? Because we have completed the user creation part. Now I've started the user allocation, so I've created user groups called cohort. Next, I'll be discussing what are the different roles present in Moodle and how can you assign user roles to different users. So any doubts or if it is clear, please confirm in the chat box. Great, thank you. Right, so there are certain other options in the account section. If you see user management, this is just going to give you an information, since it's an admin account that I'm working with, it is going to give you an information of the fields that are available with the user account. And if you want to remove any field or save changes, you can do that. Then there is user default preferences or uploading pictures and user pictures in bulk. So these are extended options to the basic operation of user creation and deletion. Next, in the permission section is the part where you will be allocating user roles. So if you can see here, we can assign system roles individually to a user, and we can also assign system roles or user roles to a cohort, right? So both sort of an options are available. If we want to see what are the different user roles, what are the definition of different user roles, then this option here, define user roles, you can see manager role, course creator, teacher, editing teacher, non-editing teacher, student, guest, authenticated user, all different kind of roles are available to you. Now, this can vary depending upon the privilege with which you are working. I'm working with a site administrator privilege. So I have the option of deleting this role or editing certain information or privilege that is to be presented as a part of this role. I want to change the role assignments, or I want to override certain role privileges. I can do that if I want to, being this site administrator. Or if not, I can just see what the user role means. If you want to see what is the description of a user role and what are the privileges available with the role, you can visit this page of defined roles under the permissions section, right? If you want to create a new role as a site administrator, you can do that. If you want to create a new role, you can even click on this option, give a more customized role name of your type. Like if you want to create a director role, or if you want to create a head of department role, and you want to give it certain privileges, you can do that here by creating a new role. Now, if you're working from the cloud account, maybe some options may differ. Otherwise, if you have your on-premise implementation or the administrator user ID password, other things will work fine. So let's move back to site administration, user section. Now in the permissions tab, there is this option called site administrator, second. So there is one main administrator and there are some potential users. You can, being a site administrator, you can add potential users to the site administrator or the main administrator section, and you can also remove, because I am logged in through a site administrator privilege. If you're logging in through any other lower privilege than site administrator, then certain operations can be restricted. So we generally do not fiddle with this part. We let the site administrator be as one super user and only allocate different types of roles assign system roles like a manager or a course creator role. So as I discussed, manager is a lesser privilege or a more restricted role than the site administrator, which is used to just manage or handle courses. So if you click on manager, there are no roles with manager privilege. You can only allocate role to a user account that has been created into the system. So we have many potential users here and none of them are site managers. So all of you working on the cloud account have manager privilege, right? Now, if I want to allocate a potential user to be manager, I say make Siya Kumar the manager. So it will give Siya Kumar access under the existing user section, right? Can move back and check whether the addition was done successfully. Users, assign system roles. Now it shows me here. Manager, one manager is present in your system and that is of the account Siya Kumar. Now if I want to add a course creator, I say let user 2 be a course creator. Add it to the selected section. Go back again to site administration, users, click on assign system. So you see here, we have one manager and one course creator. If you want to delete the same or if you want to remove the person from the role, click on course creator. I want to remove this person from the course creator privilege, remove. Check site administration. Users, assign system roles, course creator is now zero. So this is how we are allocating privileges of administrators, managers, and course creators. The other two type of roles, students and teachers, they are related to courses. Managers and course creators exist at the system level. But when we talk of teacher role, editing teacher, non-editing, as well as students, these are related to courses. These are specific to courses. So in order to allocate or assign a student to a course, enroll a student within a course and assign a teacher to a course, you will have to perform the operation of course enrollment. This will be detailed in the second half of today by Uttam sir. As far as the user roles and privileges go, we have seen how we create different type of roles, how we allocate privileges, basic privileges using assign system roles, how we can change the definition of roles, how we can create cohorts. And if we want to assign user roles to cohorts, like if I've created a cohort of say multiple users and I want to allocate it manager roles. Right now, I don't have as many managers there to assign privileges to the cohort. Then I can do that through this section. Otherwise, in the second half of this session, we will also be seeing how to enroll cohorts into a course. Like you can individually enroll students in a course and you can also enroll cohorts in a course. So both options are possible and they are a part of course enrollment. So far, different user roles, user creation, updation, deletion, singly, bulk. Then we had different user roles, how we create managers, course creators, how we change the definition of every role and how we function with cohorts. If anybody has a problem so far or are not able to perform any action or have any doubt, please let me know. The last section here on the users tab is the privacies and policies. So if you want to check the privacy settings, it can be right from here. Yes, ma'am. A user can be defined in more than one role. It will not restrict. If we see here, assign system roles. Course creator. I want to make Siya Kumar the course creator also. She was already the manager. I have made her the course creator. So I can check here. Now the same user is present in both the roles. System will not differentiate that a user is present in one role, so cannot be there in another. For system, it has to be just a user account. Now, whatever logical role privilege grouping that you want to give at your own discretion is up to you. Only thing is, the user should first be present into the system. You should have created the user. That's it. Anything else? Anybody wants to discuss anything? Any doubts? Any queries? For that, you have to change, like under the manager role definition, you have to change that not just individual users, but a cohorts can also be managers. So where we saw defined roles, there you have to make certain changes, and then this can be possible. Like it is not mandatory, it's not hard and fast that whatever the Moodle LMS is offering as a role definition has to be carried on. We can change the definition. Site administrator can change the definition of multiple roles. And then we can perform this action. Right now, there is no role of this sort in the user context. It makes sense to have just one post creator or one or two different users as post creator and managers. Any other queries? Anywhere you're facing a problem, if you've implemented practically, please let me know. Next session, Uttam sir will be continuing from this point where he'll be enrolling teachers and students into a course enrollment. If it is clear, you can confirm in the chat box. Things were clear to you. there are no queries, then probably we can close the session. If that is comfortable, please confirm in the chat box. If there are any questions, extension points, more than happy to answer. Please let me know.
If all participants are clear about the different usage roles that ma'am has explained, can we finish this session? Request all my participants to kindly confirm. Few of them have already confirmed. Fine. In that case, I think most of the participants are confirming. So thank you, Tanya. It was again a wonderful session on user creation roles, teachers dashboard and Moodle LMS. I thank you again for this wonderful session. Please accept this certificate from our side as a simple token of remembrance. And with this, I also thank all my participants. We draw curtains to the first session of the day along with this. The second session will begin sharp at 4, for which we'll again reopen this room at 3:45. So thank you all the participants, and thank you Tanya ma'am so much for this wonderful session. I think we'll draw curtains to the first session of the day with this. Thank you so much.
Thank you ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you to all participants.
Thank you ma'am. Mani.